Or maybe you're just an overprivileged poppycock, living on daddy's pension and protesting about the unfairness of capitalism. Maybe stock market manipulation is your bag, or loan sharking, double identity theft, assassination, or even worse, swinging. On our next episode, I, Stephen Haynes, will show you the flashier side of crime in Los Santos. Illegal street racing, cocaine, and vice. Yes, speed, snort, and sex. The alliterative threesome that helped hook America on the underbelly of paradise.
In times like these, it's important to remember the good things. Sure, the economy may be a little rough, and we may be shuttering schools, hospitals, and libraries to pay union pensions, but San Andreas is still the place where dreams are made. This is where counterculture began and then morphed into a nanny state. A place that preaches environmental stewardship, but has a terrible public transit system and the worst air in the world. Experience more of San Andreas, the suburban sprawl. No sense of community, and no building more than 30 years old. Where fluffy children's theme park animals are both our heritage and our culture. San Andreas leads the country in removing pristine first growth forest to build generic strip malls and tract mansions. San Andreas, we won't be broken hypocrites forever. Brought to you by the San Andreas Tourism Board.
You can cancel that gym membership because Fat Chips have all the crunches you need. Finally, snacks have gotten healthy. We've taken the humble but deadly potato chip and taken away a whole lot of fat and added a whole heap of fat.
Damn!
Confused? You won't be. With a controlled exercise and diet plan, the pounds just fall off and the fat gets radical. Yeah! It's time to take health to the streets. It's time to make health cool. Try all new healthy flavors like radical sour cream and black licorice quinoa, funky honey mustard greens and ketchup prawns, chipotle wheatgrass, Bavarian car key party, dry Greek rub greens, and Norwegian salmon rancher surprise. Yum! Fat Chips. Get crunching and stop crunches. We've made healthy snacking cool.
Princess Rabbit Bubblegum!
What are you doing, Master?
I'm reading the comments on your recent videos. These people are a little...
They're a bunch of horny, lonely perverts.
Those are your fans. Be respectful. Do not bite the hand that feeds.
Okay, so what are they saying about me?
Oh, let me see here. This one said that your boyfriend is too feminine. Like he played both sides of the sushi bar, but he don't like fish or surf clam. He only like octopus. But this is a terrible analogy. Where's that useless cutesy sidekick of yours that walks on the tips of his toes? What the hell?
Are you okay?
Oh, he's fine. It's just a concussion, a massive internal bleeding or something. Poke him.
That wasn't Saki's illicit booze bath. Something is going on outside.
Ah, so definitely now this guy really dead. He's like a 40 pancake. Oh, we could license that. Yes, that's what we do. License part of a balanced breakfast. Princess Robot Bubblegum, crispy snatchy pops, and special furry pancakes.
Oh, no!
Oh, the ancient ones warned this day would come.
What ancient ones, Master?
Oh, those geriatric tight asses at the bank. They say they're gonna foreclose on me, knock down the secret temple, and build a 24-hour drive-through massage parlor with, the human traffic Australian chicks. They love it. You don't even have to leave your car. You just reach through the window, wanky, wanky, wanky. Hey, bloke, you want a cockatoo? You
know. Okay, good. Okay, girl, there is a big wrecking ball outside, and they're gonna smash your house down.
We know!
Calm down, bitch. my hair.
Master, you taught me discipline. Why haven't you paid the bills?
I was very distracted. I have a 300-year mortgage to pay and my pension got cut. It's hard time for everybody.
Pension? I thought you was an ancient ninja master is what you told me.
I am. Many years ago, I was an ancient ninja postmaster for about 5 years. Then I retire on a 275-year pension. I can throw a postcard across the room and give you a terrible paper cut. The post office was horrible. Licking, stamping, licking, and licking. God damn it, it's like dealing with my second wife. Your face goes numb, you take a coffee break, you turn back to a soul-crushing job that leaves you feeling terrible afterwards.
Hello, master? How are we gonna save our house?
Fuck the final. Wait, merchandising!
But master, since the last DVD got edited by censors in the West, we don't sell so many. So no more merchandising. No more Princess Robot bubblegum dolls, or pencil cases, or rulers, or blow-up companions, or love balls, or erotic massage oils, or all the other creepy shit you've sunk all our money into.
Sometimes the path is not straight, but it's still true. Oh, I like that line. I like that. Maybe I sell it on a bumper sticker. Anyway, the path of truth is still the path of merchandising. Personal merchandising. Merch, merch, merch.
I never knew you worked in marketing.
Oh, it's easy. Any fool with half an MBA can do it. Listen, you will save our house in the time-honored way. You will please horny men one after the other. They will be standing in line for a chance at you, and we can charge them $20 a pop.
Master, I won't be a massage girl.
No, stupid bitch. We go to comic convention. You sign an autograph, and we sell some more action figures. We rebrand the erotic oil as a personal usage erotic oil for the lonely lover, and the branded socks to clean yourself up with afterwards. You know, it's prostitution of a different kind, but legal personal merchandising. Oh, it makes my loins ache.
Oh, this is so exciting. Never in my years of being a blind androgynous child with a huge sword could I have imagined such wonders.
Yes, truly the script writers have reached new heights. Time for an incongruous clip of an arousing girl fight. You've gone out with.
Master, what are you doing?
Fair. Fuck that little blue raccoon. We'll get you a new one.
Master!
Oh, please. Oh, please. Nihao na. Nihao na. Turn off the water. Shut up! Cry me a river. You're a big girl. This is exciting rebranding opportunity. Nothing sells like a cute animal sidekick. We have auditions. We'll change them every season. Flavor of the month. Fuck it.
Humpy. Griffy.
Grindy.
Smokey.
Poopy.
What the fuck? Where are we, Germany?
Okay, you do.
Humpy, humpy.
Audition over. Blind boy, kill the rest. Come on, we've got to get to the convention center and save this ancient temple.
Just some my shit on the floor.
Princess Robot Bubblegum is brought to you by...
No-Go Vodka. The new premium vodkas come from a place where everyone's depressed, most people are unemployed, and a few rich people have stolen all the money. Not Russia, the Midwest. No-Go. Premium vodka from the heartland, not the motherland.
Oh, this place smells something terrible. It's like a fat person's armpit, Cuddy, for real. And nobody's buying nothing.
That is my special vapor machine. It attracts nerds with the smell of unwashed loneliness. It is very powerful. That's why I bring this.
When the battle rages hardest, every warrior knows you have to fend for yourselves. Put that shit on a sticker!
I thought your last film was really lacking. Anime has moved beyond your hackneyed stereotypes. Close. made from belts. An emo character. Tentacle rape. It's just such a cliche. It's not like in Rapefest Quark Zoom, where they subvert the cliches by embracing them and then undermining them by making them all true. But then that's written by a genius, whereas your show is such a hack job. Seriously, where do they find these people?
Are you going to fucking buy something? Oh, have you met Humpy? He's the hot new sidekick.
You're old news. The future of anime is Shiny Wasabi Kitty. She's awesome.
Wait, who's that?
That is Shiny Wasabi Kitty.
Hello, nerd.
I trained her many years ago. She was my pupil. But she turned evil.
Girl, I'm blind and I knew that bitch was evil. I could smell it. She had sulfur spewing down south. And she is overtly sexy, but also tough and good at fighting, just like every nerd really wants.
But how is she evil?
Oh, she won a larger cut of residuals. I tell her you are just like my last boy band in ass.
I like boy bands.
She seems to be doing just fine without you.
All right, girl, listen to what we need to do. We need to sabotage that bitch. We won't get rid of the competition, okay? Come on, Humpy. You with me, girl?
Humpy, sabotage!
Listen up, listen, listen. You listening, okay? Let's do something really impressive that we haven't figured out yet and get people liking our show again. That's what we're gonna do. By the way, how I look?
Humpy, Humpy!
Oh! Her sidekick is humping! It's so postmodern! I wanna buy a t-shirt!
What a cute, horny sidekick. How about you come on my show? I'll give you 5%.
Humpy, like percentages? Winky, winky time!
Stop that! That's demeaning to women!
No, it's not! This is great! It's art!
Who are you to determine what's demeaning to women?
It's not demeaning. You subvert the cliches!
I am the cliches. Look at me.
Bitch fight!
From me, you fucking whole bag!
Stop crying and start fighting! Take your clothes off!
Stop indulging them! Watch this, it's just as much fun!
Wait, whoa!
Uh-oh!
You try!
Wow, that felt liberating, right?
What's happening? I love you, Princess Robot Bubblegum!
Still lose the house, and now we have no fans left. I'm sorry, Master.
Are you kidding me? I got the whole thing on my smartphone. Put behind paywall, make episodic, or merchandising.
Merchandising!
And subverting all the cliches.
And now, if I could get you two to maybe, kiss or delicately fondle each other, or even not so delicate.
Humpy, freeze frame time!
Oh no, why are you on the ceiling? Is it the anti-gravity gun again? Shit nozzles.
No, we've been shot with the anti-narrative gun. This episode makes no sense.
Oh, yeah. Oh, we ran out of ideas how to end this episode. So I'm just gonna sing a song to you. How come you smell so Asian, but you look so Caucasian? I can't get next to your love, girl. I'm gonna break you in half, little Japanese woman. I like them big eyes like saucers and a small mouth like a mouse's ear. Get rid of that sister.
is Emmanuel.
Oh, yeah.
Shut the fuck up, singing plant-ass bitch. How I look?
When my dad had a heart attack, we rushed him to Central Los Santos Hospital. I was so scared. Thanks to the treatment he received there, he unfortunately died.
My family learned our lesson. That place sucks.
Heart attacks won't kill you. The wrong choice in hospitals will. Take your loved one to Mount Zona Medical Center. Mount Zona is number one in heart attacks, brain hemorrhages, Tourette's,
fuck shit cunt,
strokes, hemorrhoids, leprosy, elephantitis, cardiac failure, and loose stools. You have a choice in hospitals, so pick the one with the largest advertising budget, Mount Zona Medical Center.
American plastic surgery is too expensive. Why not do like the rest of American industry and reduce your cost by going abroad? Implant Outsource, the reality show that sends contestants to exotic locations for permanent body modification. Pirates love booty. Why not get ass implants in Somalia? Take a relaxing vacation in Mongolia, the land of Genghis Khan, and get your legs lengthened. Or a second penis installed in Tijuana. Implant Outsource, Mondays on CNT.
Impotent Rage, the liberal superhero.
Save the day for straight or gay.
Impotent Rage.
Tax the rich, not the poor, even though he bought his body offshore.
Impotent Rage.
Get Eco Awards in a jet plane.
We're sacrificing together. I feel your pain.
Impotent Rage.
Eat organic, recycle, or I'll have a fit.
He's a judgmental hypocrite.
Union entitlements rule. Ban God in school. Smack for junkies. Welfare for flunkies.
Impotent Rage, the liberal superhero.
I just care too much.
What do we want? Less work!
When do we want it?
Now!
What do we want?
Hand jobs!
Everyone get back to work! What the hell is this? Get back to work!
Impotent Rage. Impotent Rage.
Safety first. Hey, fellas, what's going on here?
Oh, Impotent Rage.
Thank God you're here.
We're being oppressed by an evil corporation.
Our bosses want us to actually work.
It won't guarantee us 200% raises.
Summer Fridays off and pensions for life after retiring at 37.
Why, that's outrageous.
But we're going out of business if we don't make some changes. They want free snacks, massages, and raises every year. And most of them go on disability with full pay anyway.
You revolting chiselers, you!
They're trying to fire me for sleeping at my desk.
You were drunk!
Well, you would be too. He's just deadening the pain inside from being trapped as a mediocre cog in the dead-end machine of capitalism.
But he's the CFO!
I said American workers should be able to retire at age 35 and receive health care and a salary for life on your dime. Otherwise, what's the point?
That's impossible. That's not how economics work. Don't you understand? I'm extremely rich.
I understand how economics work and what the working class needs.
They want a six-pack of beer, an eager girl in their pickup truck, and a depressing folk tune playing on the radio.
This here's a free country, boy! Free, but with thousands of rules and regulations to keep greedy corporations like you in line.
If you don't like it, move to China.
But because of the free trade agreement, that's where we'll have to move the company if we don't want to go out of business. We just want a sensible discussion of the issue.
Oh, you're nothing short of a disgrace.
If peaceful protest won't change your mind, we're going to have to solve this the old-fashioned way. With mind-bending, liberal, impotent rage! A victory for the working man!
My worker is done.
but our workplace is destroyed.
Ah, hell go on welfare. Kick back, get a six-pack and relax. You deserve it after all this work.
Well, we just want to work.
Braxton Industries, headed by billionaire liberal playboy Braxton Hunter, recently celebrated the closing of another highway to install more bike lanes and collective urban farms. Braxton recently returned from a trip to Antarctica on his private jumbo jet, where he'd been to accept an environmental award. Some critics say that Hunter is also the caped superhero Impotent Rage because they look exactly alike and have the same voice, and Impotent Rage tends to show up right after Mr. Hunter quietly sneaks out. He has emphatically denied they are the same person.
A hero of the liberal media, others say Hunter is a rich, entitled asshole with too much time on his hands.
What? I am not a rich, entitled asshole with too much time on my hands. Woo, baby! Now that is one productive day's work. I'm gonna go home and do some yoga, drink some wheatgrass, and go to my favorite farmer's market.
Good morning, Braxton. You look great. You've got a bunch of voicemail messages.
From who?
Uberman.
Uberman! My arch nemesis! I hate that right-wing bully!
Hey, Impotent Rage, you pathetic hypocrite. I was just eating some whale sashimi and a manatee steak when my thoughts turned to you. Dumb, slow vegetarians whom the state will no longer protect. See you around, schmucko.
Oh, do I hate that man.
Oh,
do I despise
Braxton,
him?
Braxton, there. I know a way to calm you down. Something wet and relaxing that you'll really like.
Oh, a flaxseed smoothie. You've got a great idea, baby.
Braxton, I need to tell you something. I'm in love with you. I want you to take me, rip my clothes off, and thrust yourself inside me. Sometimes I feel like you don't even notice I'm here.
I'm sorry. What were you saying? Oh, it's okay. It's okay. I get emotional about this stuff too, Violet. The environment, marriage rights, hemp clothing, recycling, plus Santa cakes. You know, I became a liberal at a very young age. My parents were... Violet, we're about to start the flashback sequence, so please wiggle back and forth for me now.
Okay.
My parents moved here as immigrants from Vice City and built a huge empire, exploiting people mercilessly. My father made a fortune strip mining, whaling, dumping toxic pollution, and marketing tobacco. He was a womanizer. And much more interesting than me, he belittled me constantly. And then he died before he could write me out of his will. And so I became the majority shareholder in a huge multinational company. I traveled the world. I joined lots of NGOs and did what any other impossibly rich, sexually confused rich kid does. Became a superhero. Through the art of self-meditation, yoga, and a freak green energy accident, which gave me unnatural godlike powers, I became Impotent Rage. Wait, what's that?
What is it?
It's my echo sense going off. That man isn't recycling.
Hey, Neanderthal, do you know what century it is? Recycle that soda can, or I'll come down there and teach you a lesson you won't forget in a hurry. I can't stand being disrespected like this.
Braxton, quick, to the anger room.
Wow. Oh my God. All this relentless, self-righteous pasturing. It's exhausting. It's exhausting. What is it? High-tech device of the future I personally invented, even though I am otherwise entirely incompetent?
Impotent Rage, there's some trouble down by the river.
Fascism never sleeps. Violet!
I'm over here.
Of course you are. Why are you wearing that ridiculous outfit?
I thought superheroes run around in their underwear, so should their assistants.
Violet, it's that kind of hyper-sexualized clothing that exploits and demeans women.
Fuck me.
Fuck me! Time for impotent rage!
Where is it?
Here.
For the record, this is an organic, entirely fair trade cotton one piece that is dyed in berry juice, harvested by a lesbian commune. And it's every bit as effective at fighting crime as the synthetic fibers made popular by some of my rivals. Quick, to the suit-up montage!
Braxton?
What's this?
That's the cost to animate your overly elaborate and lengthy suit-up montage.
Got it. Okay, skip the montage. Let's go straight to
Impotent
Rage! Impotent
Rage!
We'll be back after these with our show!
There are over 8 million species of migratory birds that travel through San Andreas. But every day, hundreds of thousands of birds are slaughtered by a not-so-silent predator, windmills. So-called environmentalists' desperate need to destroy our state's indigenous oil industry will lead to noisy, nature-killing windmills, literally, in your backyard. At San Andreas Water and Power, we're working with state and local officials to make sure that windmills and solar panels don't ruin our pristine environment. Let's keep the power on. Nature, and in particular our beautiful birds, will thank you. Nothing is more dangerous for a bird than a slow-moving windmill. They, like any half-sentient creature, much prefer 100-acre industrial plants spewing out noxious chemicals. Let's all work together to preserve our environment. San Andreas Water and Power.
Want to stop us from fracking. You conservatives! Always trying to stop loving people from fracking. What century are you living in? If these three men want to frack each other, what business is it of yours? If these two want to spit roast this guy, why do I care?
What? But they want to drill really deep and make a mess.
Why, they say that's the joy of fracking. Why, I'll bet this happy fellow is a top! I say what? Fracking is what makes the world go round. Everyone is free to frack who they want, what they want, and where they want. I myself would frack all the time if it weren't that my superpowers have adversely affected my fracking prowess. Oh yeah! I do love big, delicious penises. You have to help us, Impotent Rage. We'll be in oppressed.
I've had about enough of your Stone Age outrage! You angry conservatives are all pent-up homosexuals yourselves!
Hey, but we're not conservatives, we're protesters! Hey, what's going on? What are you doing?
There! That should sort things out for everyone. You just keep on fracking, boys. Does anyone want a photo for their Life Invader page? I really do exist. And I prove, not all closeted rich guys are creepy.
Oh, Impotent Rage. You're such an ignoramus.
Uberman! You littering pig!
I was wondering when you turn up.
Oh, my suit is so fancy. This suit is actually pleasuring me right now. Oh, who's your daddy? Who's your daddy?
Yang!
You've worked yourself up into such a liberal lather that you actually ended up helping the opposition. These are natural gas wells that pollute the environment, not three old queens into P&P.
What? Oh, no, what have I done? Maybe I'll donate some money to charities. Build a statue of a kid in a wheelchair? That will clear my conscience.
I've come to save the day again from you. The common herd needs a genetically superior synthetic fiber-clad sociopath lunatic to look up to. Not a soy latte-sipping dweeb with a flaccid... Well, you get the point. But first, I'm off to
drill some oil wells in environmentally sensitive wetlands. Goodbye, impotent rag.
No! I must stop him.
To the impotent mobile, electric car! Initiate solar panel sequence right away!
The conservatives always win.
This is America. Our fires burn bright, especially in the trash barrels that keep people warm, or after a riot because there's no jobs. America is hurting. We're at each other's throats, wondering if this country can ever come back from the abyss while bankers loot the coffers. The thing about steel, it's hot and cold at the same time, like a woman, Lady Happiness. We made the problems, and we're solving them together, because we're in this together, which is why it's only right you're paying for the mistakes we made together. Subpar cars and overly entitled executives. Together,
Grand Theft Auto 5.
Created in a nation that's 95% condemned. We haven't forgotten what America wants.
Yeah, so this car has been held on a routine traffic stop. Get over there and commandeer the vehicle before they move it on.
Let's get to work. There you go. Now drop it off and take the credit. As usual, someone's holding up the rest of the group. When they're finished on their car, you can go. Installed. Not bad, you ask me.
Okay, it's us against them out there. We've put a lot into this deal, so let's get it done. Bring the cars to the buyer, look out for other organizations. That's it. Let's do this, people.